Thank you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we gather together to celebrate this, the Word becoming flesh, we are mindful of what a great mystery this is, that Christ's divinity becomes part of our lowliness, and part of our lowliness becomes part of heaven. For those times that we have failed to use our earthly flesh for the best of its divine purpose, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord of Mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burdened them, the pull on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster. You have smashed as on the day of Midian, for every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains, by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I would also be remiss if I did not thank the moms and dads and the nan of the kids up at the altar, and Chloe and Annabella that have read for us today, to make sure that they got here safely and after a long, hard day's work, you know, probably the last thing on earth they wanted to do was to come out. But thank you so much for the gift of your children. You know, we have the saying that Christmas is for children. And these fine altar servers, these two excellent readers, and all the kids in the parish that are involved, it gives me great joy and great hope for the future of the church. And they truly have some great parents. The other day, I normally have the TV on for noise, and I had one of the higher up channels on of the old time shows, and Jack Benny was on. And for some of you a little bit too young, like Gary Borman, to know who Jack Benny was, he was a wonderful, very straight-faced comedian. And for a while he had a TV show. And he had a black butler slash chauffeur by the name of Rochester. You remember him, Rosa? Rochester. It was like one of the first teaming up of black and white people, and it was truly remarkable. But poor Rochester, Jack Benny in his role was always a bumbling, wealthy type of person that took things for granted and never really paid much attention. And Rochester always made him feel good. Well, this was a Christmas show. And Jack Benny has Rochester drive him to Macy's department store. And they're walking through Macy's, and Rochester's looking at Jack Benny weird because Jack Benny's really a fish out of water in a department store. He doesn't know what he's doing. And finally, Jack Benny gets the hint that Rochester's looking at him weird. And he said, "Rochester, we're here in this department store because it's Christmas." And he says, "I am here with you to buy you your Christmas present." Now, Rochester, you know that most people don't have the people they're buying a gift for with them. But you know, occasionally, Rochester, I forget. And he said, "So we're here at Macy's so I don't trip up and duplicate the gift that I got you last year." And then he says, "Rochester, what did I give you for Christmas last year?" And Rochester says, "Mr. Benny, it was a crisp, brand new $1 bill." And all of a sudden, Jack Benny gets quiet. He said, "I gave you a dollar bill for Christmas?" "Yes, you did, Mr. Benny." And he says, "Oh, Rochester, you must have missed the present I left for you back at the house. I was only joking when I went and gave you the dollar." And Rochester says to Jack Benny, he said, "I wish you would have told me that sooner because I cried myself to sleep that night." How many times have we cried ourselves to sleep? How many times have we fretted? And how many times have we worried? Crying to sleep isn't fun. And crying ourselves to sleep sometime, there are circumstances that are beyond our control. You know, my dad hated Christmas. He despised me. My mother was Mrs. Claus. But my dad despised Christmas so much because it was on Christmas Eve that my grandfather left he and my grandmother for another woman. And that scarred my father's life all the way up until the time that he was an adult. I'm sure my dad cried himself to sleep that night as a 13-year-old boy. But since then, he always hated Christmas. But yet, when we came around, my brother and sister and I, he wanted Christmas to be nice for us. But my dad had one problem. He always spent more money than what he should have. And then in January and February, when the bills would come in, he'd fret and cry himself to sleep once again. None of us are particularly thrilled about this pandemic. And Schuylkill County has one of the highest infection rates in the state. For a little tiny county, that's hard to believe compared to some of the metropolitan areas that we have. And it's all because we want to always do it our way. We want to make sure that everything is perfect, even though nothing is perfect. And so we fret and we fray over Christmas gifts and Christmas cards and Christmas dinners and Christmas presents and Christmas decorations and Christmas caroling and trying to visit everybody and trying to please everybody. And trying to please everyone, we please no one, especially ourselves. So if we do what we should be doing with this COVID, this should be the best Christmas we should ever have. Not so much in terms of presents and fine meals, but because we have to be together in our own little pods, and we're really asked not to associate with too many people outside of our family circles, the people we live with. We've been told to avoid crowds. Maybe this is the time that we get back to the true meaning of Christmas. That Jesus is the reason for the season. And as Santa Claus is how good he is to each and every one of us, I think Santa Claus is even embarrassed from time to time that he gets more attention than the Christ child who he himself has come to serve. My mother always liked to get up very early. This was her favorite time, Christmas. Because while the house was quiet and everyone's asleep, she would get up and she would turn on one tiny stable light. And she'd sit there and stare for hours at the manger. And she would recite the St. Anthony Novena over and over and over again. Hail and blessed be the hour and the moment in which the Son of God was born. At midnight in Bethlehem in the piercing cold from the Blessed Virgin Mary. What a wonderful prayer. Only you and I can warm the coldness of the night that Jesus came. Only you and I can make comfortable the straw in the manger. Only you and I, through our love, can feed him on the milk of contentment. Yes, this might be a different Christmas. And yet, we're all getting tired of COVID fatigue and being told what to do and what not to do. But as we heard last Sunday, when Gabriel came to Mary, she didn't play 50 questions. She didn't say, what do I get out of this? But rather, she said, let it be done to me according to God's will. And Jesus himself lived a life of poverty and humility and total obedience to the Father. And as the Philippian hymn says, taking on flesh and dying on the cross for our salvation. Sometimes we get way too caught up in the lights and the presents and Santa Claus that we forget really why we should be spending this time in church tonight. It's because Jesus is the reason for the season. And he will help us through not just this pandemic, but all the difficult times we experience in our lives. May God bless each and every one of us. May we kiss 2020 goodbye. May 2021 be a lot better. But most especially, this is my 12th Christmas with you. I truly have been blessed. And I've told you from the start that this is the best parish in Schuylkill County. It's because of all of us working together and making the Word become flesh among our brothers and sisters and the downtrodden and the poor in the world. Let us pray that the Holy Spirit blesses us with the gift of the Christ child the way he did Mary, so that the Word becomes flesh through our very actions. Merry Christmas to you and to your families. Before we begin the creed, one thing I did want to mention is that the reason we had the procession with the figurines this year is because that nativity set I found crawling around an attic. And it was there for years, and it was in a bad shape with disrepair. And someone said, let's see if we can get it restored. And so it's a beautiful set. It's been a part of the history of the Catholic Churches of St. Clair for many years. And just like we did the first time we gathered here 12 years ago, I took all the sheep from all the different churches, and they're all still over there. So that's the reason why we carried that up when we blessed it tonight. At the words, he became man. If we could all just take a moment and bow or genuflect for the Word becoming flesh. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not have an end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On this blessed night, we rejoice because our Savior has been born. Let us pray for the Father, who has shown his endless love by sending us his only Son.
To the leaders of our church, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that through their work they may continue to spread the good news of our Savior, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of our church throughout the world, they may share the joy of this holy night and rejoice in the light of faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, that they may follow the example of Blessed Mary, who so lovingly welcomed the infant Christ into her life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, especially parents and children, that all families may appreciate the true spirit of Christmas giving, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of all who shared our Christmas joy in times past and present, that they may come into eternal glory. Let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, you sent your only Son into the world, truly God and truly man. Mindful of your great gift, we confidently place our needs before you. In Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept that sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the cause of
the Church. May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we proclaim. On the day before he was to suffer, He took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Especially all our departed parishioners and all our departed family and friends. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all the saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with Him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of your Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night, draw far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue, forever and ever.
Amen.
May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives, and make you heirs of his gospel forever and ever.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gifts of his peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven forever and ever.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
I also, before we leave to celebrate Christmas in our own little ways, I'd like to thank our wonderful choir. Their dress rehearsal was kind of snowed out, but I don't think you needed a dress rehearsal. So thank you very much for all that you do to make our worship very nice. And thank you for all of you coming out here tonight and participating. Once again, on behalf of Justin and our entire parish staff, a blessed and a Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Father Bill, please join with us with one verse of Silent Night, followed by Joy.